guys, I hope you're doing well and enjoy your day. So, a couple of weeks, I received the Amazfit Bip, this little smartwatch, and here's what I like and what the improvements I want to see in the next revision of this smartwatch.
First of all, let's talk about the design. I really like the style and the square shape of the smartwatch, and it just hugs your hands. It's tiny and very lightweight, and almost you don't feel it. I'm wearing it while I'm sleeping without any issues, and I never notice it overnight. I was more on the circular design, and my first smartwatch was a Find Hue X3, a fully Android device which has a round screen, but it couldn't last more than 2 days, and I replaced it with a Xiaomi. Moving to the features, the number one for me is the huge 15 to 20 days with a single charge. This is amazing, I couldn't believe it. That's what I need from a smartwatch. So the reason for lasting so long is actually the screen. The technology behind it is the translucent color display. With this screen, the light goes through the screen and lights the screen without the need of a backlight. And this is usable under the direct sunlight. Also, it packs a backlight to use it in the absolute dark. The 1.28-inch touchscreen is how you navigate and scroll through the different menus. The next important feature is the IP68 waterproof resistance. According to IP68, you can use it under the rain or even when you swim because it can resist up to 20 meters underwater. You can use the smartwatch technically when you take a shower or when you wash your hands without any issues. Personally, I don't use it on the shower because I want to eliminate any damage. Going through to the different menus, in the status menus you can see it supports pedometer, which can calculate the total steps you make for a day and also the total distance and burning calories. I check the total distance, if it's accurate and it's pretty accurate I can tell. I make the same distance when I went out for running and then again with my car and it was almost the same. There's also the Mi Fit application and you can check all of this in the app. In the app, the distance as you can see is 2.58 km and with my car was 2.52 km. Also, heart rate sensor is available to help you monitor your current heart rate during peace and while doing sports. In the activity menu, you can choose running, treadmill, cycling and walking with the help of the acceleration, geomagnetic, barometric and pressure sensor. You can monitor your outdoor activities. When you start an activity, you can wait for the GPS to locate you or skip it, and then you can monitor the time that activity takes, the kilometer that you cover, your speed and all that kind of stuff. In activity history, you can see with the help of the built-in GPS the route that you did. And if you are using a bike or a motorbike, it's very useful if you found a new route to see it on a map and be able to make it again or sharing it with a friend. Next is the weather that is synchronized with the app if you are into that. I personally never check it at the moment because the weather is always sunny and it might be interesting in the winter. There is also the alarm app if you want your smartwatch to act as an alarm. How it's making that is with the help of an inside vibration motor, which is working as an alarm mechanism to wake you up. Moving in the timer menu, there is a stopwatch or a countdown options if you wanna have that directly to your hand. I used it once and it was very useful actually. It's nice to have features right to your hands. Next is the compass application to check the current pressure, altitude and all that stuff. There are some features you can only check via the application on your phone. The smartwatch connects through your phone via Bluetooth. In the application there is a sleep monitor and you can check your quality of sleep at night. Also you can check all your activities through this and add notifications for incoming calls, messages and for any other application you need. To notify you is using the vibration motor. On the settings you can change the watch face and I personally changed the watch face to a custom one using the app Notify and Fitness for Amazfit, but there are so many apps of them in the Google Play Store. For iOS users, I don't really know. Sorry guys. All of them are the features that pack that smartwatch. Additions I wanna see in the next revision is maybe the support of an MP3 player. I really want to use a smartwatch with a pair of Bluetooth headphones during my exercise without needing to carry extra things. What do you guys think? Do you wanna see these features too? Let me know. Another thing I wanna see is the plastic material to be more premium, but not with the cost of extra weight or the cold touch that metal has during winter, but I like to see something more premium. If you are a fan of Xiaomi products, you know that Mi Home can control any smart device in your house. I really wanna have this app in my smartwatch to control my devices. I will make my life much easier and super convenient. So to wrap up this video, that's all I wanted to say about the Amazfit Bip. I really believe it's a good option if you want a smartwatch, and it's totally worth it. Thank you so much for watching. See you on the next one.